Hello everyone. In our last class, we learnt about problems involving measurement of weight and we solved exercise problems on that topic. Now, in this class, let us solve another exercise problems. In that fifth main, solve the first question. Radha buys 2 kg 500 gram of carrot, 2 kg 500 gram of brinjal and 3 kg 250 gram of tomatoes from a vegetable shop. Find the total weight of vegetables bought by her. Radha buys carrot 2 kg 500 gram. Radha buys brinjal, total weight of brinjal 2 kg 500 gram. She buys tomatoes 3 kg 250 gram. Now find the total weight of vegetable bought by her. Total weight of vegetables, add, we get 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 5, 5, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 3, 7. You know that 1000 gram equal to 1 kg. Therefore, now add this 1000 gram to 7 kg. We get 8 kg 250 gram. So, she bought the vegetables 8 kg 250 gram. Next, second question. A merchant has 68 kg 250 gram of wheat with him. He sells 15 kg 250 gram of wheat to one customer and 13 kg 500 gram to another customer. What is the total weight of wheat remaining with him? Total weight of wheat 68 kg 250 gram. He sells 15 kg 250 gram of wheat to one customer. He sells wheat to one customer 15 kg 250 gram. He sells wheat to another customer 13 kg 500 gram. Total he sells the wheat 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 2 plus 5, 7, 5 plus 3, 8, 1 plus 1, 2. Total weight of wheat he sells 28 kg 750 gram. Now we find what is the weight of wheat remaining with him. Now subtract 68 kg 250 gram, 28 kg 750 gram. 0 minus 0, 0, 5 minus 5, 0. Is this possible to subtract? No. Take borrow from 8. Now it become 12. 12 minus 7, 5 here remaining is 7. Is this possible to subtract now? No. Take borrow from 6. Now it become 17. 17 minus 8, 9. Here 5. 5 minus 2, 3. Remaining with him 39 kg 500 gram. Next, third question. The yield of paddy per acre is 29 quintals and 50 kg. Rajappa has next third question. The yield of paddy per acre is 29 quintals and 50 kg. Rajappa has 30 acres of field. What is the total yield of paddy? Yield of paddy per acre 29 quintal and 50 kg. But Rajappa has 30 acres of field. What is the total yield of paddy? You know that 1 quintal equal to 100 kg. Therefore, 29 quintal equal to 29 into 100. Here, we convert in quintal into kg. 29 into 100, we get 2900. Now, add this 50 to 2900, we get 2950 kg. But Rajappa has 30 acres of field. Therefore, total yield of paddy 30 acres, that is 30 into 2950. Now find the total yield of paddy 30 acres. We get 0 into 0, 0. 0 into 3, 0. 5 into 0, 0. 5 3 is 15. 9 into 0, 0. 9 3 is 27. 2 into 0, 0. 2 3 is 6. Now add 0. 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 7 plus 1, 8, 6 plus 2, 8. Therefore, total yield of paddy 30 acres 88,500 kg. Next, fourth question. 18 kg 400 gram of sugar is to be packed in 4 bags equally. What is the weight of each bag? 18 kg 400 gram of sugar is to be packed in 4 bags equally. Now find the weight of each bag. Here convert 18 kg to gram. You know that 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. Therefore 18 kg equal to 18 into 1000. We get 18,000. Add 400 gram to this one. We get 18,400. 18 kg 400 gram of sugar is to be packed in 4 bags. Now divide 18,400 by 4. We get, you know that 4 fours are 16. Now subtract, remainder become 2. Now write down 4. Now it become 24. You know that 4 6 are 24. Now subtract 0. Now write down 0. 4 zeros are 0. Remainder become 0. Now write down 0. This one 4 zeros are 0. Remainder become 0. Therefore, weight of each bag contain 4,600 gram of sugar or 4 kg 600 gram. You know that 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. Next, fifth question. A farmer gets 60 kg 400 gram of onion from one field and 50 kg 800 gram from another field. If he sells 98 kg 200 gram of onion, find the weight of onions left with him. A farmer gets the onion from one field, 60 kg 400 gram. He get the onions from another field, 56 kg 800 gram. Now total onion he gets from the field, add 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 8 plus 4, 12, 0 plus 6, 6, 5 plus 6, 11. You know that 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. Now add this 1000 gram to 116 kg. We get 117 kg 200 gram. Total onions he get 117 kg 200 gram. If he sells 98 kg 200 gram of onion, find the weight of onions left with him. If he sells the onion, onions left with him 117 kg 200 gram minus 98 kg 200 gram. 0, 0, 0. Is this possible to subtract? No. Take, borrow. Now it become 17. 17 minus 8. We get 9. Here remaining is 10. 10 minus 9, 1. Remaining onions left with him 19 kg 0 gram. Next, observe the vessels here. Observe these vessels. In figure 1 and figure 2 are the two containers filled with milk. Figure 1 and figure 2 are the two containers filled with milk. Can you tell which container contains more milk of milk? Can you tell the approximate quality of milk container in each container? It is not possible, isn't it? It is not possible to know the quantity of milk contained in each vessel. We should measure the volume of milk. Now let us study what is volume. What is volume? Volume means the total quantity of liquid contained in a vessel is called its volume. The total quantity of liquid contained in a vessel. Milk is a liquid contained in a vessel. Figure 1, figure 2 are the vessel. So total quantity of liquid contained in a vessel is called its volume. So the measurement of volume is expressed in cubic units. The standard unit of volume is liter. The standard unit of volume is liter. Decaliter, hectoliter and kiloliter are the standard units to measure liquids with greater volume. Decaliter, hectoliter and kiloliter are the standard units to measure liquids with greater volume. Deciliter, centiliter and milliliter are the standard units to measure liquids with lesser volume. Now let us try to know more about these standard units. The word deca, hecto, kilo, deci, centi and milli are prefixed before the word liter. Observe, units of greater volume, units of lesser volume for 1 liter. Deca means 10 times, units of greater volume. Hecto means 100 times. Kilo means 1000 times. Units of lesser volume for 1 liter. Deci means 1/10 part. Centi means 1/100th part. Milli means 1/1000th part. These units shows the number of times it is contained in a liter. Next we move on to comparison of greater standard units of volume with 1 liter. Observe the table carefully here. 10 times 1 liter means 10 liter. 10 liter means 1 deciliter. Next, 100 times 1 liter. 100 times 1 liter means 100 liter. 100 liter means 1 hectoliter. Next, 1000 times 1 liter. 1000 times 1 liter. 1000 times 1 liter means 1000 liter. Observe here, 1000 times 1 liter, we get 1000 liter. 1000 liter means 1 kiloliter. Deca, hecto, and kilo are the greater standard units of volume. Next, we move on to comparison of smaller standard units of volume with 1 liter. Units of volume with 1 liter. You know that units of lesser volume for 1 liter, deci means 1/10 part. 1/10 of 1 liter equal to 1/10 liter. It means 1 deciliter. Next, 1/100th of 1 liter. 1/100th liter. 1/100th part means centi. It means 1 centiliter. Next, 1/1000th of 1 liter. 1/1000th liter. 1/1000th part means milli. 1/1000th liter means 1 milliliter. Now, the standard units of volume used in daily life are the standard units of volume used in daily life are 1 liter means 1000 milliliter. Next, 1/2 liter, 500 milliliter. 1/4 liter, 250 milliliter. 1 kiloliter, 1000 liter. These standard units of volume used in daily life activities. The word liter is written as small letter L and milliliter as small ml and kiloliter as kl. This is about volume. So dear students, in this class we learnt about what is volume. Volume means the total quantity of liquid contained in a vessel is called its volume. And also we learnt the standard units of volume is liter, and we learnt comparison of greater standard units of volume with 1 liter and comparison of smaller units of volume with 1 liter and the standard units of volume used in daily life activities.